People are visual. We absorb visual information so easily and share feelings to make decisions. For most of us, it's really hard to judge a building by looking at architectural drawings. We want to know, how does it feel? In Minneapolis, we see this as fundamentally important to municipal planning. We think that development application site plan review will eventually occur in virtual or augmented reality. Public engagement will include VR experiences. With platforms like what the U of M is creating, which enable multiple people to go in together, shared experience and conversational critique are possible. This is how people make decisions. We couldn't be more excited about the partnership.
Minneapolis is undergoing a period of incredible growth. After decades of suburbanization in our region, there's a renewed interest in investing in our central city. Downtown Minneapolis is at the center of all that. We've got 160,000 jobs downtown, 36,000 people live downtown, and both are growing. It's the epicenter of a region of 3.5 million people, the 15th largest in the nation. In selecting a site for this virtual reality pilot with the University of Minnesota, there were two main ingredients that we needed. One, we needed a site that was in a part of town that would really get people's imaginations going. And second, we needed a developer and architectural team who was willing to do this. We were lucky that we found both. We have a great site in the Fresher Square development site downtown and a great architectural and development team, Sherman Associates and ESG, local developer and architect. The Fresher Square site is in the east side of our downtown. This area is undergoing a major renaissance right now. Most of the neighborhood is under construction. A new Viking stadium is under construction for our local NFL team. There's a new park being built on two blocks in front of the stadium, and it's surrounded by hundreds of apartment units under construction and 1 million square feet of office space. So this development site, Fresher Square, is just down the street. There are a lot of eyes on this area, to say the least, so it's very important to the city to get this right. And that's where virtual reality can be especially helpful in this instance. This is a cultural destination in this neighborhood. It's right on the riverfront. We have a lot of amenities on the Mississippi River, including the Guthrie Theater, the Stone Arch Bridge, and many other destinations.
At the Virtual Reality Design Lab here at the University of Minnesota, we allow people to enter immersive virtual environments using a system involving several components. The first is a large-scale optical tracking system. This system allows us to track users within a 50-foot diameter circle, allows untethered freedom of movement, and allows us to have multiple users in the tracked area at the same time. Users wear a head-mounted display that was developed in-house that uses an iPad mini as the display and the computer, a 3D printed housing, and special optics. The iPad functions as the graphics computer, generating 3D stereoscopic images of a virtual environment based on the optical tracking it receives from the tracking system. Our custom software running on the iPad synthesizes both the tracking data and the 3D model data into a seamless, immersive experience for the virtual reality user.
When we first began this partnership between the City of Minneapolis and the College of Design at the University of Minnesota, our first step was to generate some excitement. So we brought in department heads from the city, even a city council member, some key policy aides, members of the Planning Commission, to simply try out the system as it had been applied to date. In the field of urban planning and design, 3D models are commonplace. We use them every day. But with a head-mounted display, you can put yourself in that virtual environment. You can feel like you're actually there. This is the future of our field.